Chromatography is a method used by chemists to separate substances by the use of a mobile phase and a stationary phase. The mobile phase carries the substances that are supposed to be separated, and the stationary phase is used to restrict the movement of the substances. The difference in the properties of the substances is what allows them to move in the different phases. The two main factors that allow this separation are the solubility in the mobile phase and how well the substance is absorbed in the stationary phase. In this experiment, we'll be separating the dyes found in various powdered drink mixes, and then we'll be determining the dyes in an unknown drink mix. For this experiment, you'll need the following: 5 capillary tubes, a 600 milliliter beaker, a 50 milliliter graduated cylinder, 1 piece of chromatography paper, a pencil, a pipette, a porcelain well plate, powdered drink mixes, and a ruler. In this experiment, you'll be working with a partner. One of you will obtain approximately 0.15 grams of 3 known powdered mixes, while the other will obtain the 2 unknown mixes. You'll come over to the scale and turn it on and wait for it to be 0. And then you'll open up one of the doors, take a weigh boat and set it on there. And then you'll hit tear again to zero it out and get the sample that you need and take the top off and get your scoopula and weigh out what you need and wait for it to level out. And then you want to make sure you didn't leave anything on the plate, so it's clean for the next person. So once you have all 5 of your samples laid out, you're going to take each one and place the powder in a separate well in your well plate. And you'll add 3 drops of deionized water to each. So the first thing you're gonna do when you get your paper is make a line 1 centimeter up from the bottom of the sheet, all the way across. Once you have that done, you're gonna measure in from the left corner about 3 centimeters and then make a mark every 2 centimeters. Just all the way across. So once you have your paper measured, you're going to label your lines and label the knowns that you have. And the first one will be cherry, and the second one is mixed berry. And I just put a letter, C for cherry, MB for mixed berry, and L for lemonade. And then you'll have 2 unknowns, unknown 1 and unknown 2. Take your capillary tube and put your finger on one end to not let the water come up in it and stir it up. And once it's stirred, you will soak up some of the liquid and put it in the spot where it's supposed to be. And you want to use a different capillary tube for every sample, so you don't mix them all together. And you want to do this a total of 2 times, but you want to let each spot dry in between. So now that you've spotted your paper twice, you want to get 30 mils of deionized water and put it in your 600 milliliter beaker. And once you've done that, you will take your sheet and a piece of tape and fold it without making a crease and tape the edge of it, but be sure not to go in too far so the spot isn't in the same line as the tape. And once you have that, you will put your sheet into the beaker, trying not to let it touch the sides, and then you'll let that sit for 10 minutes.
Eventually.
So once your paper's dry, you'll take your ruler and make a mark at the top of each color in your mixture. Then you'll use your RF equation to measure the L value, which is how far your spot moved from the original line. And you'll do it for both of them. Your RF equation is D over L, where D is how far your spot moved from the original line, and L is how far your solvent moved up the page from the original line.